can you call me back? And I'd be like, why are you so obsessed with me?
Of giving my all and never being enough. I'm tired of changing for people who don't even recognize my change. I'm tired of crying myself to sleep at night and waking up in the morning and not recognizing myself. I'm tired of not being thin enough or pretty enough. I'm tired of not being enough.
You might be too big or too small in their eyes, but you're the perfect size for the heart that's meant to love you. You might be too outgoing or too shy in their eyes, but you got the perfect personality for the heart that's meant to love you. You might be too black, too brown, too white in their eyes, but you're the perfect color for the heart that's meant to love you. Never let how they feel about you change how you feel about yourself. Brenda, change because you want to. Because you want to. Not because someone's opinions, judgments, or preferences forced you. Let go of everything that's keeping you from loving yourself.
I remember when I took this video, I thought, a year from now, I'm going to be so different. I said, I'm really invincible, hold. It's 100 niggas in the spot. I won't keep going. I won't keep going. It's 85.
She's confident, oh no no, oh no no, and I'm down with it, oh no no, oh no no, she's confident, you tell her the way she walks in the room.
She said it's that first time, yeah, I think she might have lied, feels so good.
Okay, like, don't get me wrong, I look alright. I be getting burnt. Back in my day, my heart. Y'all shouldn't have let the world gas me, because it's too late. They let me in. I'm here. World's feeling what I'm doing. Y'all shouldn't have let them. Y'all shouldn't have let me in.
Imagine the day they see you again. And you are just, well, better.
I be popping bottles, sparkles and champagne. VIP my section, royalty looking sexy, you know that be my thing.
Don't let 1 year from now you wish that you started a year ago. Start now.
I want to glow up. You want to have a glow up? Trust me, I'm the girl that you want to talk to. I've had the biggest glow up in the last 6 months, and I'm not here to boast, but also, I don't even know her, okay? She is dead to me. I don't want to know her. I don't talk about her anymore. No, I've definitely just toned up a lot. I feel like my skin is glowier. My hair is more healthy. And then, like, mentally, I'm happier. I'm more in control. I'm more confident. I know what I want. I'm just a well-rounded version of myself. I'm still growing. I'm still always evolving and becoming better. But I'm here to tell you what works, okay, and what I've done. Okay, we're gonna start really simple. Water. Drinking lots of water. And I know that sounds really silly, but a lot of us forget to, especially in the colder months. So I just make sure to carry my water bottle around with me. I know we all do it. This is roughly 1 liter, so I try to drink 3 a day. Everything's better with my water, my skin, my energy, a lot of things. So we'll start simple, lots and lots of water. Number two is journaling. Now, for someone who doesn't journal, trust me, I understand it's really hard. But guys, especially if you're struggling mentally, getting that shit down on paper, okay? Get it out of your head, because what I can almost like 100% guarantee, it's never as bad once we put it down on paper. Especially anxiety, it tends to build up, and we tend to make up scenarios that aren't even real. Journaling, writing it down, like even just writing every single morning, what I've been doing is 5 gratitudes, 5 affirmations. And if I feel I've got something heavy, I just try and journal about it and come up with some kind of a solution, or just like write it down and be like, okay, actually, you know what? I'm way more in control of the situation than I thought I was. So 5 affirmations, 5 gratitudes every single morning. But also if you feel like you've got something going on, please guys, I know it's such a, like, it's hard task sometimes, but try and journal about it. The third thing is 10,000 steps a day. I can very easily do this because I live by the beach and I'm the sunny Gold Coast. I understand it's not possible for everyone, but if you can get outside and get some steps in, trust me, you guys, there's times where I'm sitting in my house and I feel like shit, right? As soon as I get out and I have the fresh air and I'm strutting down the boardwalk, I'm a different person. And 10,000 steps, you guys, are just so, so great. First of all, for digestion, my bloating is so much better, but also it's just so good for you. So good for your body to make sure you're still walking. I'm pretty sure that's one of the things that keep us the youngest, if we could just keep on moving. So I try to do that. I do 10,000 minimum a day, and I break that up. So if I haven't done my 10,000, I'll just do another walk in the afternoon. It's so good for you. The fourth thing is happy podcasts. I've tried to do the personal development podcast. They're just not for me. So podcasts that make me laugh, and I put them on, and if I'm in a bad mood, laughing, I'm having a laugh, and that just serotonin is boosted. Okay, so Happy Hour with Lucy and Nikki, one of the greats. Those are my two, Inspired Unemployed, The Girls Bathroom, Sophia and Chintzia. They have me cackling, okay, and instantly mood is boosted. Mood is through the roof when I'm listening to one of those. I'm at the bars and dentist, made the whole eat me for dinner. Whoa, whoa, pain, all in my eyes, I can't see.